resource officers from Madison and Middleton districts worked together to track down students believed to be in possession of handguns.
And now the guns turned out to be BB guns, but as our Keely Arthur reports, the charges are no less serious. Keely?
Yes, these were three very real-looking BB guns, making the danger feel very real to students and police officers.
There was no actual threat to any student or staff member.
But the situation started off much scarier when two students in a vehicle allegedly pointed a gun at a Middleton student. A police officer stationed at Middleton High School sent an email alert to other officers in the area
and said someone in the car, a teenager, had pointed a gun at someone at Middleton.
The alert included a description of the car, a white Buick without a front license plate, ringing a major bell for a fellow school resource officer at Memorial High School in Madison.
When the Memorial SRO saw this email, he immediately recognized the description of the car as one that likely some students from Memorial would be driving.
He took a screen grab of the car he was thinking of off surveillance footage.
The Middleton SRO said, yes, that indeed is the car.
Shortly thereafter, the suspects were located, as were three very real-looking guns that turned out to be BB guns, in a car parked at nearby Jefferson Middle School. The students were arrested for possession of weapons on a school premises.
We do know that there are a lot of teens who are carrying real guns. So if you're driving around with a fake gun and you point it at somebody who has a real gun, again, there may be real bullets being fired in your direction.
This is a story that ends much better than it could have, but one that has no shortage of lessons to be learned.
Hopefully, the word is out, both here in Madison and in Middleton, that if you're driving around with BB guns, there are very real repercussions.
Now, there were also reports of car windows being shot out by BB guns in Memorial High School's parking lot. Police are currently investigating to see if the two incidents are connected. Both school districts are weighing in on the incident as well. We have their full statements up on channel3000.com.
Two high-ranking members of the Milton School District say they plan to resign at the end of the school year. Board members say Superintendent Tim Scheiger and Director of Administrative Operations Jerry Schutz made the decision themselves, and they were not removed from their positions. The resignations come after a third-party investigator was hired to look into $30,000 in stipends paid to district employees without board approval. Two of those stipends were given to Scheiger and Schutz. Ultimately, investigation found no intentional wrongdoing. The newly elected president of the school board there says he is grateful for Scheiger and Schutz's leadership, hard work, and commitment to making things better in the district.